So now we are going to study the disciplinary process. First of all, we would like to talk about progressive discipline. What is meant by progressive discipline and the different examples of the steps in progressive discipline. Then we will go into the disciplinary process and we will talk about other aspects of disciplinary process. So what is a progressive discipline? So it means that the employer imposes gradually from a less severe discipline process to a more severe discipline option. So it means that gradually the whole issue or the discipline thing becomes more difficult with time as the person moves through the process. So initially the employee is given oral warning, then if the employee doesn't rectify himself or herself, then written warning is given. If that doesn't work, then suspension is given. If that doesn't work, then demotion or transfer is done. And lastly, if it doesn't work, then the employee is discharged from the workplace. So now we are going to look at all these steps of the progressive discipline. So first of all, we have oral warning or a reprimand. So it means discussing about the misbehavior or performance deficiencies and then telling the employees to take the necessary steps to improve the performance. And then the next step is the written warning. That means if the employee doesn't rectify, then a written warning is given to the employee regarding the performance deficiencies. And in the writing, the future actions that need to be taken, that is also mentioned. And in future, if the deficiencies remain as such, then further disciplinary action will be taken. After that, the employee is put on probation if the employee doesn't improve. So during the probation, the employee's performance is expected to improve. And at the end of the probationary period, the employee's performance is again evaluated. Then if the probation period doesn't work, then the employee is given suspension. That means the employee cannot come to the workplace and the employee may not be paid during this time. So after that, if the suspension doesn't work, then leave is given without pay and the employee goes through a more formal disciplinary hearing. And if it doesn't work, sometimes the employee is also given a demotion. That means the employee's high status in the organization is downgraded. If the employee's performance doesn't improve, sometimes the organization also needs to discharge or terminate the employee. So during the termination, there are two options. One is termination with right to rehire. That means the employee might be considered for hiring again in the organization. Or the next one option is the employee doesn't have the right to rehire. So in very severe situations, the employee is terminated with no right to rehire. That is if the employee's offense is very severe. So progressive discipline is not always applied in every situation. It depends on the circumstances, and if required, the organization might go straight to a higher level of disciplinary action like termination. It depends actually on the type of offense that the employee has done. For example, if the employee has done a criminal offense like theft or murder, in that case, the organization will directly go for termination. So whatever is the procedure that is followed, it is very important to document the reasons, because this will act as a reference for future discussion, and also the employee gets to know what is happening and why the disciplinary action is taken. As a result, the employee can actually understand that where is the lacking, and accordingly the employee can take the necessary steps. So these are the results or outcomes of the disciplinary action. The employee might go for development, that is the employee might be able to improve his or her performance. Sometimes the employee might build up a resentment That means the employee might feel that there has been a violation of the psychological contract, that means the mutual expectations. So this can create frustration among the employee. The third possibility is an employee separation. That means the employee might leave voluntarily or the employee might leave involuntarily. Also, sometimes the employee withdraws from the work. So it could be a psychological withdrawal. That means the employee, although attends the office, doesn't get involved that much in the organization's task and decision making. Or it could be a physical withdrawal by the employee. That means the employee is not coming to the office properly on time. And the last outcome of the disciplinary action is the reactions that the bystander or the co-worker will have. So if the co-worker sees that an employee is going through a disciplinary action, that co-worker might also become frustrated. So this disciplinary action will have some consequences on the co-workers of the employee. So these are the possible outcomes. There could be other outcomes as well, which are not listed over here, but these are the major outcomes of the disciplinary action.